Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Kayleigh if you are new to me. If you're not, I'm so glad you guys are continuing to join. Today's workout is going to be a back to the basics type of workout, right? So no props, just your own body weight. We're gonna do a full body workout, but I'm really going to explain everything and move slowly so you guys can focus on your form. All right, so go ahead and grab your mat or whatever you're working on, grab some water, and we're gonna get started. Hold at the top, take a nice stretch, up and over to the side. Good, bring it around all the way to the front, come up to the other side, switch the grip here and just lengthen, relax the shoulders. Good, sweep it around all the way to the other side, one more time each way. Making sure to find that breath, inhale and exhale, bring it back to center, inhale, reach those arms up. Exhale, bring it all the way down, bring those hands to the floor, start to soften the knees, bend the knees, and press. Shoot the hips up towards the ceiling. You can have your hands on the floor, on your shins. Hold the belly in and away from the thighs. You have four more. Three, two. Next one, you're gonna hold it down right there, walk the feet in closer. So you wanna zip up the inner thighs. Make sure there's no space there. Bring the feet all the way together. Bend the knees and then lift the arms up. So you come into this nice chair position here. Start to find a little pulse. You have eight, seven, six, five, four. Keep squeezing together. Hold it here. Lift the right heel up. Lift and lower. Switch. Lift. Lower. Good. Try to keep those knees bent. Stay low if you can. Four more. Three. Two, next one, hold both heels up. Hold, try to find a balance here. Squeeze those inner thighs together. You have four, three, two, reset. Bring the heels down, hands go to the floor. Alternate bending the knees, right and left. Feel that stretch through the back of the legs. You have four more. Three, two, now we're gonna hold it down right here. I want you just to come up into a flat back. Relax the shoulders. So your hands come off the floor. Bend the knees just a little bit here. Feel the belly pulling in. And then bring it right back down, all the way down, hinging from the hips, bring it right back up halfway. Good, all the way down, tap the fingertips to the floor, bring it right back up. So you're gonna feel that through the back of the legs, lengthening through the hamstrings. You have four more. Three, good, go as low as you can. If you can't touch the floor, that's okay. Halfway lift. Good, on this next one, hold it down right there. Bend those knees, lift the arms back up. Now the feet are hip distance, hold it right there, little pulses. You have eight. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, same thing here, lift the heels. You have right and down, switch, left and down. Good, so now with the legs apart, a little bit harder here, not as stable maybe, or maybe more stable, depends, right? So find what feels best, find that position that feels comfortable but challenging. Work right here, four more, three more, two, last one, hold them up right here. Now this is gonna feel hard with the legs not squeezing together. Try to keep the legs from buckling in or going out. Keep them parallel. You have four, three, two. Bring those hands to the floor. Right from here, come to the back of your mat. Just hang heavy and then walk the hands out. Find your first plank, hands come under your shoulders. Pull the abs in. Send some energy through the back of the heels and squeeze your glutes. Keep the neck nice and long. Take a downward dog, nice and slow. Pipe those hips up. Press the heels towards the mat, let the chest open. Pedal the feet out. Good, so pressing one heel down at a time, you have four. Three, stretching out the calves. Two more. Last one, you're gonna come right back into that plank. This time, I want you to round the spine. Scoop the belly in, reset, come into your plank. Drop the shoulders down and back. Open those fingertips apart and really press through all your fingers, your palm, and really ground yourself here. Hold that plank, don't move, just find stability. Close your eyes here, you have eight counts to hold it. It's eight, seven, slight tuck of the tail. Good, you have five, four, three, two. Start to shift your weight forward and back. So you're going up on those toes, back on your heels. Nice and slow and controlled. Option here, if you need to come to your knees, you can work in bird dog. You can work on your knees. Good, four more. Three, inhale, exhale. It's two. Good, really lengthen, feel those quads. Next one, hold center. Good, now take your left foot, cross it on top of your right ankle. Hold that there, start to shift forward and back. Good, so start to feel those obliques, the side abdominals working. As you shift the weight a little bit more on that right side, you feel the left working, right? Three more. Two, hold it center, lift that left leg off, point the toes, little pulses for eight. Seven, six, five, four, squeeze your glutes. Two more, one, place it down, hold. Take a nice slow downward dog, recover here, pedal those feet out, right and left. Good, pull the belly away from your legs, right? You wanna think about pulling the belly button in and up. Opening the chest here, letting the head go. You have four, three, two. Next one, you're gonna round the spine, come back into that plank, hold. Good, now we have the other side. You're gonna lift the right leg. Place the toes on top of your left ankle. Now putting more of that weight on that left side, but feeling the right side engaged. Obliques are fired up here on the right side as you shift forward and back. Pull the belly in and breathe. Inhale through the nose, exhale out through the mouth. You have four more. Three, getting some wrist mobility in here. Two more. Good, next one, you're gonna hold it center, lift that right leg, point the toes, little pulses here. Lengthen as you lift. You have eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Place the foot down, slowly take that down dog. Good, from here, you're gonna walk the feet in towards your hands. Hold it right there, and then walk it right back out, come into a full plank. Good, now you're gonna walk the feet. Tiptoe all the way up, and then tiptoe all the way back into that plank. Good, give me one more like that. Tiptoe, walk it in, pike those hips up towards the ceiling, and walk it right back out, holding that plank. Your last eight counts to hold here. Good, breathe it out. You have six, five, four, three, two, one, take a child's pose, drop those knees down, reach the arms forward. You wanna open up the legs here. Nice deep breath, press the hips back towards the heels. Just let the head go and reach those fingertips long. Let the back, the spine, feel that stretch. Good, and then come right onto your hands and knees. From here, we're gonna bring the knees closer together, right underneath your hips. We're gonna drop those forearms down. So now shifting to our forearms, your elbows come underneath your shoulders. Pull the belly back in, square the hips off, send the right leg out, reach the toes nice and long. Good, so as you do this, try not to open up, right? You wanna stay square to start. Lift the toes up, lift the leg 2 inches higher, hold it there and start to pulse, little pulses here. Good, lengthening that leg, pointing the toes, reaching up towards the ceiling, give me eight. Seven, six, five, four, three, two. Now hold it there, don't move, little circles. Good, one direction, we'll reverse it. Don't hurry if you're going a different way. For four, three, two. Now reverse, take it the other way. Draw that circle, it can be as small as a quarter. Keeping the hips stable. Good, breathe, you have four. Three, pull the belly in, two more. Next one, hold it up right there. Flex the foot, little pulses, lift, lift. Good, now you're sending that heel up towards the ceiling. Deep breath, you have four more. Three, two, one, hold it. Now you shift, take that left arm, bring it parallel to the front of the mat. Take yourself up on that right hand, turn the hip out, all right? So now from the hip, your toes slightly point out. Now you lift up, give me 3-4 inches higher. I want you to go higher on this one. And now pulse it right here. Pulse, pulse. So now you feel a little bit more of that side booty working, side body working. Deep breath, you have eight more. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Hold it at the top, draw that knee in towards your elbow, and then press it back up and kick. So you draw it in, use the abs, press, 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 lift and kick. Good, everything else is trying to stay stable. Using your breath, inhale, press and kick. Exhale, inhale, And exhale. Relax your shoulders. Almost there. Good. Four more. Three. Last two here. Last one, you're going to hold it up right there. Hold it up. Lift it up another inch. Hold it. Press and reach. So a little bend and press. In and out. It's nice and small. Every time you press, you reach that heel longer. Eight more. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. And one. Bring it in. Take a nice stretch right here. Take that child's pose if you need it. Take a downward dog if that feels better. We're going to switch to the other side. Same thing on the other side. Coming down to those forearms. Good. Make sure those knees are under your hips. Lift the left leg, point the toes, reach it long here, and start to pulse. Just a little pulse, down and up. You have eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Now we have those small circles. One direction, make a small circle as you lengthen the leg. Hips are stable, abs are pulling in, relax your shoulders. Keep the neck long for three, two. Now reverse it, other direction. That's it, stay with it. You're gonna start to feel those little muscles burning. Keep breathing, inhale and exhale for four more. Three, two, one, hold it right there, flex the foot, little pulses, pulse up. Now that heel is reaching longer, up towards the ceiling and back. Good, for four, three, two, one, hold it right there. Take your right arm, bring the forearm parallel to the front of your mat. Press yourself up on that left hand. Open the hip up. Now you let that hip open so your toes go out to the side. Lift it up higher here. So try to lift it as high as you can go. Feel that glute, little pulses. Up, up. Here, give me eight more. Seven, six, five. Pull the belly in. Good for three, two, one. Now hold it, draw that knee in towards your elbow. Press it out and reach. Good. Draw the knee in. So you want to keep everything else stable and press that heel back. Extend. As you extend, try to lift up one inch higher. Good. Knee comes in. Press, reach. Knee in. Press, reach. Beautiful. You got this, guys. Stay with it. Give me four. Three. Good. Two more. Next one, we're going to hold it up. Hold it up right there, lift it a little higher, bend, press, good. So it's in, press, reach, eight more. Seven, good, keep the neck long. You got this, guys, give me four more. Three, two, and one, bring it in. Take a child's pose. Open those hips up, reach the arms forward. Good, right from here, you're gonna curl the toes under. You're gonna come into that down dog position. You're gonna walk the feet in. Carefully, slowly roll it up bone by bone. I want you to articulate that spine. Take a nice big inhale, reach those arms up. Exhale, you're gonna walk it out nice and wide. Send the arms out. Sink nice and low into that second position. Plie squat, little pulses here. Keeping those arms strong, shoulders strong. You have eight, seven, you have four. Three, two, now pause, don't move the legs, sink one inch lower. Now can you hold that right there, keeping everything nice and open? Press the arms back, press. Good, so we're not using weight today, so I want you to create the resistance with your own body weight. You press back like you're moving through that water, right? We always say that, press. Hold the legs, you have eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, now hold, leave the legs, little pulses up, a little bit quicker now. Good, so you want your pinky finger up towards the ceiling, thumbs down. Pulse it up, you have eight more. Seven, six, five, four, stay with it. Good, now hold it there, don't move. Hold the arms, keep the arms, lift the left heel, lift the right heel. So you have left and right. Back to basics, guys, this is it, you got it. Lift. So feel the calf muscles working. Feel the inner thighs, feel the quads. Eight more, eight, seven, stay strong. Five more, four, three, two, one. Now hold, palms down, reach over one side, pull the elbow in. Opposite side, reach, grab something, pull it in. Then you send it back out. You reach, pull center. Reach, grab, pull center. So I want you to notice the obliques working here, those side abdominal muscles as you reach and lean. Good, pull in. Elbows behind the back, pull. Send it out, pull. Four more, four. Yes, three more. Two, stay low with the legs. Last one, you're gonna hold it, palms up, just cross and open. Now add that little pulse as you do this here. Re-engage the legs. I know they were working just holding, right? Those isometric holds. But now I want you to move them. Little pulse. Make sure you alternate right hand over left hand over right. Nice and simple. Stay with it. Four more. Three more. You want a little break for those legs. Two more. It's coming. Last one. You're going to hold right there. Good. Extend. Reach all the way. Sweep the floor. Lift it up. Sweep, sweep, lift. Sweep, sweep, all the way up. Good. Get low. Pull the belly in. Lift. This is the most dance ballet type of thing we'll do, I promise. All right, it doesn't have to look like a ballet move. Just let the arms go, bring them up. Sink low and lift. You got four. Come on, it's three, two. Next one, hold it all the way up. Good. Sink it low. Drop it down. Flip the toes forward. Flip them out. Flip it forward. Flip it out. So you want this to come from the hip. Turn in, out. In, out. Good. For four. For three. You got this. Two. It feels a little weird, right? Next one, you're going to hold. Now you're in this weird stance. Pull the belly in, knit the ribcage together. Start to shift and tap down. Shift. Shift. Now you move right into those lateral lunges. Opposite hand to foot. Reach and add that small rotation. Eight more. Seven, six, five, four, three, two. Hold it, whatever side you're on. All right, now we're going to turn over to that side. Come into your nice runner's lunge. Hands go down. Back leg is straight. Float that front arm up. Whatever leg is in front, that same arm goes up. Take your twist. Take a nice big inhale here. Exhale, float that hand back down. You're gonna pop yourself up into your lunge. Hold the belly in, bring those hands to prayer. So I really want you to press into your hands. Let the elbows rock to the side. And then shift that back leg in just a little bit. You want your knee in line with your ankle, that front leg. Little pulses here. Pulse down and up, down and up. Good, you have eight, seven, six, five. Keep pressing the hands together. Good, hold it there. Hold it and turn. So now if your left foot is forward, I want you to turn over to the left. If the right foot is forward, you turn over to the right. So whatever foot is forward, that's where you turn. Okay, so I want you to rotate and twist. Bring it back to center. Relax the shoulders. Press into the palms. Good, holding that lunge nice and strong. Four more. Good, inhale, center. Exhale, twist. Good, can you give me two more? Yes, hold it. You got one more here. Good, bring it back to center. Arms go up. You're going to pull that back foot in and back. Arms reach down as you pull the knee in, tap it down. Good, you don't need to drive that knee up, but if you want a little extra, lift the knee, tap back. Lift the knee, tap back. You're going to keep that standing leg bent. Good, breathe it out. Arms sweep up and down. Keep it strong. Four more. Three more. Good. Back to basics, right? We said that. So keep it nice and controlled. Focus on the form. Next one, we're going to hold it back. Hold. Good. Now float those arms back right there. Hold that stance. You want to keep all that tension in that front leg there. Shifting forward just a little bit. Your hips are shooting back. So you're in that hinge position. Just float those arms up and down an inch. You lift and lower. Fingertips reach. Neck is long. Good. Keep it there. Eight more. Seven, six, five, four, three, two. Now hold it. Circle those arms in. In. Good. Feel those triceps. You got this. For four, three. Lots of circles. Good. Reverse other direction. So we're doing something similar with our arms we do with our legs, right? Small circles in, small circles out. Go to your 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold it, lift the arms 1 inch higher. Good, now can you flip that back leg off the ground? Hold it there, find a balance. Breathe, we're just holding for 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring the hands, bring the leg down. Come into that runner's lunge. Good, nice and controlled. I want you to float that arm up again. Take your twist, breathe. Good, bring it right back down. We're gonna come back through center. You're gonna shift side to side one more time here. Tapping opposite hand to foot. Opposite hand to foot, you got this. Breathe. Two more, next one, hold. Good, now turn, come into your runner's lunge to the other side. Back leg goes straight, front knee is bent. Hands go down, float that front arm up. Whenever foot is forward, that same arm goes up and you twist. Good, bring it back down. One more time, float that arm up. Good, bring it right back down. Find yourself that lunge position here. Bring that back foot in a little bit. Press the palms together, let the elbows go out. I want you to really feel those muscles engage with the upper body. Little pulses here. Good, breathe. Inhale, exhale for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Now hold it right there. You're just gonna turn and rotate over that front leg. Good, so whatever leg is in front, that's the way I want you to turn, okay? So make sure that turn is coming from the center. It's coming from your core, your spine. Press the palms. Good, breathe, 4 more. Stay low in the lunge, 3 more. Inhale, exhale, last one. Good, you're gonna hold it center. Hold, reach those arms up. Good, from here you're gonna take that back foot in. Tap back, arms reach up and pull down. Good, so again, you're in that hinge position here, belly pulling away from the legs, right? Obviously, it's not. Belly's not on the legs, but I want you just to imagine that, right? You're pulling it back towards the spine, lifting it up, relaxing the shoulders. You got this. Breathe, 4 more. 3, 2. Next one, we're gonna hold. Now send that leg back. Sweep the arms back, good. Keep the toes down, sorry, keep those toes down. Find your balance in that little hinge, right? So the hips are going back, you feel that glute of that front leg, you feel the quad, the foot is pressing into the floor, just pulse the arms up, up. So draw those shoulders down and back. Good, breathe, inhale, exhale, lift. Fingers are reaching. 4 more. 3 more, our second set of circles. Good, you're gonna hold it right there, small circles in. Good. Deep breath for 4, 3, 2. No matter which way you went, just go the other way. Good. I think I went the opposite of what I said. Beautiful. You got this. 5 more. 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold the arms up. Can you lift that back foot off the ground? Good. Find your balance. Lift the arms. Draw the shoulders down and back. Hold 3, 2, 1, bring those hands and legs back down. Come into your runner's lunge one more time. Flip that arm up, take a twist. Good, bring it right back down. Come through center. Keep those feet nice and wide. Take a little stretch here, let the head hang. Grab onto opposite elbow, rock side to side. Good, from here, you're gonna slowly roll it up bone by bone. Take a step to the back of your mat. Here we go, inhale, arms up. Exhale, bring it all the way down. Walk it out, find your plank, second set of planks. Good, we're gonna move through some push-ups now, okay? So I want you to start in your plank, hold it strong, don't move. Find that stability before we even add the movement. Pull the belly in, slight tuck of the tail, squeeze your glutes, engage the quad at the top of your legs. Good, hold for 4, 3, 2. You're gonna give me a tiny push-up halfway down. Bend at the elbow, press right back up. Again, small, bend. And press. 2 more like this. Inhale down. Exhale, press. Hold your plank. Everyone drop to your knees. Come to an angle. So now instead of shooting that booty back, I want you to shift forward. Slight tuck of that tail. Come into that nice straight line. Now from your head to your knees. Heels towards your glutes. We're going to lower all the way down. Here we go. Inhale. And exhale. The whole body moves together. Inhale. Exhale, press. Inhale, exhale, press, right? So this is happening because we're keeping that nice angle. If we start to be here, we're not gonna be able to get that form. So continue by keeping that angle. You lower all the way down together, you press up all the way together. Good, give me four more. Three more. Two. Last one. Good, step back into your plank. Hold your plank. Deep breath here. We're gonna go for a slow mountain climber. So all you're gonna do is draw one knee in towards your chest. Send it back, switch. Knee comes in and back. Knee in. Good, so when we do mountain climbers, a lot of times, guys, we go so fast, we're not even using our core. So I want you to do these slow, so you feel the obliques, you feel the core stability here, you feel the abs working. Really draw it in, pull the belly in, point the toes. You got five more. Four, soft bend in the elbows. Three, two, last one, step it back, down dog. Good, pipe those hips up, pedal those feet out, right and left. Let's just open those hips up here. Center your left foot, float the right leg up. Good, and then bend the knee, let the foot fall. Feel that stretch through the hip. Good, bring it back to center, bring it down, switch sides. Center the foot, draw that heel down. Float the other leg up, point the toes. And then bend the knee, let the foot fall. You can flex the foot, open up that hip. Good, bring it back to center. And then come right down to your knees. From here, we're gonna take a nice big inhale, reaching those arms up, inhale. Good, exhale, you're gonna fall up and over one direction, feel that side body stretch. Then sweep your arm around, bring it to the other side, take that same stretch on the other side. So you wanna feel that lengthening through the side body. Good, up and over. Just let it flow, let this feel good here. Breathe, inhale. And exhale, we're gonna go for two more. Good, one more here. You're gonna hold it right there. And come up through center. Now you're gonna fall down onto your forearm. You're gonna kick your leg out to the side. We're gonna finish with some side lying work here, okay? So I want you to have your bottom leg bent, your top leg straight. Again, lifting up through the side body, that means both sides, bottom and top here. And you can be up on your forearm. If that doesn't feel good, you can come all the way down your arm, okay? So lifting up through the side body here, bring the leg, the top leg, to about hip height. No higher, just keep it right there, okay? Don't get fancy or anything on me here. Now you're just gonna tap the toes down and up. Tap down, lift. Tap, lift. Good, so we already worked a little bit of that side booty, the outer thigh here when we did the beginning booty work, right? When we turned the hip out a little bit. So similar muscle here. Good, and we're gonna, but we're gonna work a little bit more of that side body, top and bottom, right? So you have four more like this. Three, two, next one you're gonna hold right there. Hold and breathe, now tap the toes. Up and back. So they come forward and back, beautiful. Keep pulling that shoulder away from the ear. Inhale, exhale, so we're working side body, that means obliques are working, that means the hip abductor is working. Good, four more. Three, two, one, hold it to the back, keep it there. Pulse up right here. Now you can flex your foot, so I want you to press through that heel again. And you're towards the back diagonal as you do this. Eight more, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, hold it right there. Breathe, and carefully release. Now option to keep that bottom leg down, or just come into that side plank. Press right up into your side plank, hold it right there, reach that top arm up. Take a breath here, give me little hip dips, down and up. Good, so you wanna work that side body. Now the underneath, you're dropping and lifting. You got this, four more. Three, two, one. Breathe, hold, and slowly lower down. Good, from here you're gonna bring those knees in. We're gonna go for a few more set of push-ups. So now on the side, you're gonna wrap the other arm, so the bottom arm that was down, around your body. You're gonna bring the top hand down again, and you're gonna lower down, and then carefully press up, okay? So we're working those triceps here a little bit. We're working the side body, shoulders, breathe, good. Lower, and lift. Inhale, exhale, three more, three, two, press, you can do it, one more. Hold it halfway, little pulses, for five, four, three, two, and one. Good. Release the legs. Let them open up a little bit here. Take a side body stretch up and over. Nice job, guys. And then lift up. Just take a stretch. This one doesn't go over as easily. Feel that lengthening. Good. And then switch it around. Other side. We're going to do the same thing on that side to finish here. All right. So you're coming on that forearm. Bottom leg is bent, top leg. You're going to have extended lengthening out. Pull the shoulder away from the ear, top hand down. Lift the leg up. Hip height is perfect. Tap those toes down and up. Tap, lift. Good. So again, feeling all of this, right? Where's that corset? It's wrapped around. It's pulling everything in. Stabilizing. Breathe. Inhale, exhale. Good. So when we say point the toes, right? A lot of teachers say point the toes, reach longer, right? And you're probably like, okay, maybe. What does that mean? So when you're reaching longer, I want you to turn your quad muscle on right here. Okay, so that allows you to reach. When that quad muscle is engaged and your glutes are engaged, everything is working through the side body. The whole side body turns on, right? Good. Next one, you're going to hold it up right there. Tap those toes forward and bring it back. Good. Tap forward and back. Breathe. Inhale and exhale. Good. So you're making that rainbow shape here. Again, turn that quad on, reach, and tap, breathe. You got four more. Three, then we're gonna hold it to the back. In two, next one, you hold it to the back, little pulses here. Now flex that foot, reach that heel. Good, you have eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Hold it right there. And release. Option to keep, again, that bottom leg down. Otherwise, press all the way up into that side plank. Lift that top arm up. You go for those little hip dips. Down and up. Drop the hip and lift. Good. So you're going to feel the underneath side here. It's hard to talk in this position. Good. Breathe. Inhale. Exhale. Keep it small. Four, three, two, one. Hold it. Carefully release, bend those knees in. Now we have those push-ups on the other side. So you keep that top hand. That's going to be the arm that's working. Wrap the other one around your body. You're going to lower down here and then press right back up. So triceps are working really hard here. Shoulders are working. Good. Find a position that feels comfortable. Knees are bent. Inhale and exhale as you press. Good. 30 more. Two, last one. Good, now lower halfway down, little pulses here. Pulse for five, four, three, two, one, and release. Bring it back through center here. Crisscross those legs for a moment. Take a nice big inhale, reach those arms up. Drop one arm, take that tricep stretch. So good today, guys. We took it back to the basics, nice, full body flow, just your body weight. You can do this anywhere. You can do part of it. Good, switch sides. You're gonna feel the upper body, the lower body, the core, the breath, right? So good. Beautiful, release the arms, send the legs straight out. From here, I want you to take one ankle, cross it over. So let's open up through that hip here. Reach the arms up and then dive forward. Now you can take that stretch, that forward fold stretch. Feeling that lengthening through the hamstring, opening up the hip there. Good. Keeping that same leg crossed over, just place the foot down, lift the arms up, lift taller, and then twist over towards that side. Okay, so you can take your arm and kind of press it on the outside of your leg to get a little bit more of a deeper stretch there. But make sure you lift up and then twist. And then take your gaze over your shoulder. Good, bring it back to center. Send both legs out. Take a forward fold. Carefully roll it up. Take the other ankle, cross it over. Right from here, you take that forward fold. Now letting that hip open. You can take a figure four stretch lying on your back. You can take it standing. Whatever feels best for you. Good, keeping that ankle crossed. Just place the foot down, lift the knee up, reach the arms up, and then twist. Using that hand, sorry, that arm a little bit to press against the leg is okay. Just make sure you lift and twist so you find length before you rotate. Good, bring it back through center. Send the legs out one more time. Take that forward fold. Let everything go here. Carefully roll it up. Come to a comfortable position. Interlace the fingers behind you. Open the chest up. Good, fill up those lungs. Exhale, let the arms go. One more inhale, guys. We are focused on the breath today. Find that breath. Inhale, reach the arms up. Take in all of that good energy. Thank yourself for coming out today. Bring those hands to prayer and exhale all the way out. Awesome job, guys. That is it for today. If you have any questions, let me know. I will try to put up more of these back to basic type of workouts. So if you're new to me and you want to learn more of the movements a little more slowly, you can check this one out. If you're not new to me, it's still good to do this type of workout. Just always bring it back to basics, back to where it all begins, right? Learning form and all of the breath work that we do. So questions, leave me a comment below. Message me on Instagram. It is Kayleigh_Guinee. We will have live workouts continuing until all this craziness is over. I'm going to keep doing those live workouts. Next week, we have a fun week planned. I'm going to be co-teaching with other awesome instructors on my Instagram. So more to come on that. Follow me on Instagram to get all that information. Otherwise, just make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel. I'm trying to get to 1,000 subscribers by the end of the month. So we are almost there on both ends, right? So share, spread the word to your family and friends. Send my YouTube if someone's interested in workouts at home. And that is it. Awesome job. I will see you guys next time.